the stories about buy-to-let millionaires and their huge portfolios. But while you may expect long-term house price rises, experts say invest for income, not short-term capital growth. To compare different properties' values, use their yield. That's annual rent received as a percentage of the purchase price. For example, a property delivering £10,000 worth of rent that costs £200,000 has a 5% yield. Rent should be the key return for buy-to-let. Most buy-to-let mortgages are done on an interest-only basis, so the amount borrowed will not be paid off over time. This is tax efficient, as you can offset mortgage payments against your tax bill. If you can get a rental return substantially over the mortgage payments, then once you have built up a good emergency fund, you can start saving or investing any extra cash. Remember though, people rarely buy a home outright and they come with running costs. So mortgage costs, maintenance and agent fees must be worked out and they will eat into your return. Consider whether buy-to-let still beats an investment fund or trust once these costs are taken into account. Once mortgage costs and tax are considered, you will want the rent to build up over time and then potentially be able to use it as a deposit for further investments or to pay off the mortgage at the end of its term. You will have benefited from the income from rent, paid off the mortgage, and hold the property's full capital value.